As we are in the third quarter of Game 6 of the 2015 Eastern Conference Semifinals, the Hawks lead the Wizards by 8 as Carroll drives to his right, lays it up and in, and the Hawks are now in a 17-5 run as they lead the Washington Wizards by 10 points, and Damari Carroll has 10 points. Driving to his left is Beal, inside to Nene, to the right side it goes to Wall, driving inside, lays it up, kicks it outside to Beal, 7 on the shot clock, at the top of the circle, guarded tightly to the right wing, takes a tough shot from the right wing, it's nothing but the bottom of the net to cut the Atlanta Hawks lead to 8, 49-41, 10:25 to go here in the third quarter. Top of the key is Teague, left baseline it goes to Millsap, guarded by Nene, to the left wing it goes to Horford, to Teague at the left wing, Korver, a straightaway three-pointer is in and out, no good, rebound taken down by Nene. Hands it off to Bradley Beal at the right wing, picks up his dribble straight away to Paul Pierce. To the left wing, it goes to John Wall. To the left baseline, it goes to Gortat. Hands it off to Wall, driving inside. Missed the layup, but it's knocked out of bounds by Al Horford. And the Washington Wizards will get the ball back with a new 24-second shot clock. We are here in Game 6 of the 2015 Eastern Conference Semifinals. The Hawks have a 3-2 series lead. Straight away is John Wall. Alley-oops to Gortat, but it sails out of bounds, and the Atlanta Hawks will get the ball back. Good idea, but the pass was a little bit off target. Right wing is Jeff Teague, setting up the offense, gets a pick from Horford straight away, goes inside to Millsap, the left post, to the left wing, it goes to Carroll, driving inside, lays it up and in. Ooh, what a move by Damari Carroll. He drove inside, and he's fouled by Paul Pierce. He has a chance for a three-point play. He just took Paul Pierce to school, one-on-one, and Carroll starting to take over this basketball game as he has 12 points. As the Hawks trying to advance to the conference finals for the first time since 1970, and Carroll hits the free throw to complete the three-point play, and the Hawks with their largest lead of the game, leading 52-41, 9 minutes and 30 seconds to go here in the first half. Right wing, it goes to Nene. Right baseline to Pierce, posting up on Korver, lays it up, blocked by Millsap, and Korver comes up with it, goes up the court to the left wing to Carroll, to the left corner goes to Korver, holding the basketball, guarded by Pierce, dribbling at the left wing, right wing it goes to Carroll, left corner it goes to Korver, fakes a three, takes a three-pointer off the front rim, no good, and rebound goes to Pierce, up the court, to the left corner goes to Beal, a three-pointer is off the front rim, no good, fight for the rebound out of bounds. And the Atlanta Hawks will get the ball back. Great look for Bradley Beal. Just failed to cash in on that wide open three-pointer from the left corner. As the Hawks going from left to right in their road dark blue uniforms, leading by 11 points with 8 minutes and 45 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Left elbow, Teague setting up the offense, pulls it back out. 7 seconds on the shot clock. A left wing three-pointer for Teague. Off the rim, no good. Rebound taken down by Pierce. To Beal, back to Pierce, straight away, driving to his left, lays it up off the glass, and in! Good drive by Paul Pierce, as he caught the Atlanta Hawks sleeping on defense, to cut the lead to 9, Hawks lead 52-43. Left baseline is Jeff Teague, setting up the offense, inside to Millsap, it's a wide open right corner three-pointer for Damari Carroll, who knocks it down, to give the Atlanta Hawks a 12-point lead. Good inside-outside game by the Atlanta Hawks, and they now lead by 12. To the foul line is Beal, to Gortat, lays it up, no good, and Teague comes up with it. Teague pushing the ball up the court, driving on a fast break, lays it up and in! And the Atlanta Hawks are pouring it on as they lead by 14 points. And Coach Randy Whitman wants a timeout right now as the Atlanta Hawks are starting to pull away here in Game 6. Of the 2015 Eastern Conference Finals. The Atlanta Hawks came out of the locker room possessed. So far, they've outscored the Wizards 12-4 here in this third quarter. As Damari Carroll has really taken over this basketball game, he now has 16 points here in this game. Carroll is a very good defender and has the ability to get going offensively. We've seen flashes of it this season, as the Hawks are now in a 12-4 run, to start the third quarter. So they try to make it to the conference finals for the first time since 1970 when they lost to Wilt Chamberlain and the Lakers. It goes to John Wall at the midcourt logo, setting up the offense, guarded by Carroll, slowly setting it up, the right wing to the foul line to Paul Pierce, driving inside, blocked, but he is fouled, and Paul Pierce will get two free throws. It's what the Washington Wizards want right now, as they trail by 14 points. What they want to do is to get to the free throw line, with the clock stopped. They have some golden opportunities right here. First free throw for Paul Pierce is up. He rattles it in. Get one more foul shot. The Wizards have not made it to the conference finals since 1979. Second free throw is up. It's good. He hits a pair of free throws. It's now 57-45 Atlanta. 7 minutes and 30 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Left wing, it's Jeff Teague. Left baseline to Millsap, driving on Seraphim, losing it. Coming up with it is Pierce. Pierce goes up the court to Beal, straight away to John Wall, driving inside. Inside to Seraphim, who lays it up and in! Smooth penetration and dish from John Wall to Kevin Seraphim. Two straight baskets for the Wizards, 4 straight points, and the lead is down to 10. Teague driving inside to the left wing to Carroll. Left baseline, it goes to Teague, driving on Wall, lays it up, knocked away, but it goes to the corner. Left corner, three-pointer for Millsap, off the side rim, no good. Rebound, Pierce. It goes up to John Wall. Wall driving inside, lays it up, off the back rim, no good. Rebound taken down by Korver, no foul called. Up the court to Teague, the left wing, driving on Pierce, pulls it back out to the left baseline. 15 seconds on the shot clock, dribbling the ball at the right. The left wing is Jeff Teague. 10 seconds on the shot clock. He starts his drive on Paul Pierce. Crossover floater is up. He rattles it in. Ooh, what a tough shot by Jeff Teague. Going right at Paul Pierce. And the ball is stolen away by Kyle Korver. Teague, straight away. Shoots a straightaway three-pointer wide open. It's nothing but the bottom of the net. And just like that, the Atlanta Hawks lead is right back up to 15 points. Right after the Wizards had just cut the lead to 10. To the left wing, goes to Beal, straight away to John Wall, right wing to Beal, catch and shoot three-pointer, is nothing but the bottom of the net. What the Wizards really needed right there, but now they have to get some stops. Trailing by 12 points, and their season is on the line. Left wing, it's Jeff Teague, setting up the offense, bounce pass to Horford, inside to Millsap. The referee's trying to figure out if a Wizard touched the ball as it went out of bounds. They're having a discussion right now. What decision did they make? Having a long discussion, and I believe the ball will stay with the Atlanta Hawks, as the referees think that either Kevin Seraphim or Nene touched that ball last. Are they still negotiating? Yeah, the Hawks will have the ball. Or no, they're going to jump it up. It's going to be a jump ball at center court. Yes, they're going to have a jump ball since they can't come to a conclusion. They can't come to an agreement. There will be a jump ball between Kevin Seraphim and Al Horford. As the tap is controlled by the Wizards. The Wizards get a big break right there. Straight away is John Wall. Gets a pick from Nene. Driving to his right. Picks up his dribble. Losing it. Coming up with it is Horford. Horford pushing the ball up the court. Bounce pass to Carroll. Lays it up. Blocked by Porter out of bounds. But they call a foul. And Otto Porter cannot believe it. As I have to agree with him. I thought it was a clean block. He got all ball right there. That's a tough call. As the Wizards are trying to come from behind. That was all ball. I'm sorry. That's a tough call right there. He touched no part of Damari Carroll's body as Damari Carroll hits the first free throw to put the Wizards, to put the Hawks up by 13. Carroll has 17 points in this game. Get one more foul shot. Free throw is up. It's good. And the Hawks have a 14-point lead. 5 minutes and 25 seconds to go here in the third quarter as the Wizards go from right to left in their home white uniforms. Setting up the offense's wall, Beal straight away shoots a three-pointer over Antic, and we have a foul away from the basketball. A foul before the shot. Foul is on the Atlanta Hawks. Foul is against Dennis Schroeder. as the Wizards will inbound the basketball with 14 seconds on the shot clock. Bradley Beal will inbound at the left baseline. They give the ball to Beal. Inbounds pass goes to John Wall, guarded by Carroll with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Driving inside straight away, lays it up off the glass and in! Good job by John Wall, taking full advantage of an open lane as the Hawks lead by 12. Schroeder, straight away, wide open three-pointer off the rim, no good. Rebound taken down by Wall, who is pushing the ball up the court. To the right corner, it goes to Porter, driving inside to Nene, who lays it up, no good, but Nene is fouled. Foul is on Piro Antic, and Nene will get two free throws. That is exactly what the Wizards have to do right now. Take the ball to the basket and get to the free throw line, stop the clock, and get a few opportunities to get back into this game, as Nene will get two foul shots. He takes his time, takes a couple of dribbles, he eyes the rim. Free throw is up. It's good. The Hawks' lead is 11. The Wizards, who have played tough the entire series, they've had their share of injuries. John Wall getting injured in the first game of the series and did not play from games 2 through 4. But in all those games, they played the Hawks tough. Free throw is up, off the back rim, no good. Fight for the rebound, Nene comes up with it. Straight away is John Wall, setting up the offense. Guarded tightly by Schroeder, going between his legs, driving to his right. Puts it up off the glass and in. Ooh! What an up and under move by John Wall! He now has 15 points. And once again, the lead is single digits. Down to 9. 4.5 to go in the third quarter. Left elbow, Millsap puts it up off the back rim, no good. Fight for the rebound. And Wall comes up with it, gives it to Porter. Porter slams it with the right hand! Oh man, what a play! As he found Otto Porter on the fast break at the right side, and he delivered with the right hand jam! And Coach Mike Budenholzer wants a timeout right now! Oh man, this crowd is really loud! And now, the Wizards have life! There is life here in the Verizon Center in Washington, D.C. Timeout! We'll be back after these words!